बराबर करो सब काज, मन मंदिर उज्जवल करो, कृपा करके आज। ऐसा प्यार बहारे मैया, ऐसा प्यार बहारे मैया, चरणों से लग जाऊं मैं। ऐसा प्यार बहारे मैया, चरणों से लग जाऊं मैं, ना ये तेरा ना ये मेरा, मंदिर है भगवान का, पानी उसका भूमि उसी की, सब कुछ उसी महान का। ना ये तेरा ना ये मेरा, ना ये तेरा ना ये मेरा, मंदिर है भगवान का, पानी उसका भूमि उसी की, सब कुछ उसी महान का। ना ये तेरा ना ये मेरा, ना ये तेरा ना ये मेरा, मंदिर है भगवान का,
Thank you. Sitaram to one and all. A pleasant good evening to each and every one of you. Officiating Vyas Pundit Luchmidath Persad Maharaj, our resident Pundit Kiran Maharaj, Mrs. Maharaj, the host of this Yagya, devotees. Let me take this opportunity on behalf of the Maharaj family to extend a very cordial welcome to firstly Pundit Luchmidath Persad Sharma. Sorry, Luchmidath Persad Maharaj, for being with us here this evening and for the next two nights, actually three nights, for Ramayan Discourse hosted by the Maharaj family of Barrackpore right here. Special welcome also to Mr. Narad and members of his group. He have been singing bhajan for the past possibly an hour. We say welcome to you as well, bhai. And special welcome also to all the Shrotas, members of the Maharaj family, all the Shrotas who are here this evening. We are very much blessed to have with us this evening Pundit Luchmidath Persad. As we all know, he needs no real introduction, for he has been in this mandir for many, many years, and he have been with us in different yagyas and so forth. So without further ado, I now pass to Pundit Luchmidath Persad. Thank you. God bless.
बलुस्यावर राम चंद्र की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, शरणम। Let us all stand by the devotees and we collect our minds, bring our thoughts together as we place ourselves at the feet of that supreme being from whom we have all come. Through whose grace and blessings we dwell, we exist. And tonight, whose mercy and whose blessings we seek. हे प्रभु, हे परमात्मा, हे भगवन, आप सारे जगत के प्रभु, उत्पत्ति करने वाले, सर्व संपत्ति दायक प्रभु, सर्वे प्रकाशकर्ता, सुखदाता, thou art verily our source of happiness and bliss. At your feet, Prabhu, we manifest the beautiful flowers from the garden of our hearts. As symbols of our pure love, we place them at your feet. As tonight we seek shelter and refuge in thee and thee alone, we place our faith, our trust in thee, Prabhu, and pray again and again for thy grace, thy blessings, and thy guidance. Wherever you may be listening to us, however far from this beautiful shrine, we invite you to join with us for the next hour and so, as we glorify through the beautiful bhajans, mantras, and the inspirational messages of our sages and saints, to receive the beautiful and the most merciful messages of transformation and inspiration in our lives. Let us join together in these beautiful verses of praises as we seek again refuge and shelter at the feet of that Supreme. Hari Om. Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samprabha Nirviganam Kurume Deva Sarvakareshu Sarvada Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnu Gurur Devo Maheshwara Gurur Sachat Parabrahma Tashmai Sri Guru Namaha Siddhi Buddhi Prade Devi Bhakti Murti Pradayini Mantra Murti Sada Devi Mahalakshmi Namostute Ramay Rama Bhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Natha Sitaye Pataye Namo. I bow again and again to the feet of Madhyadi Purushottam Shri Prabhu Ramchandaji, the manifestation of God on earth, worshipped even by Shri Hanumanji, even Lord Shiva, as the source of all happiness, the fountain of ever-flowing bliss and divinity and virtue. Mentally, we offer the beautiful red flowers and tulsi leaves. We wave the symbols of our purest of love, the symbols of Aarti, and glorify the beautiful form of Sri Ram through the medium of Ramayan Aarti. Aarti Shri Ramayan Ji Ki Kirati Kali Tal Lita Siya Piti Aarti Shri Ramayan Ji Ki Shri Ramayan Ji Ki and let us meditate upon that beautiful form of Lord Bhagwan Shiva. He sits in the Padmasana, the beautiful Ganga meticulously flowing from his japa. His eyes are closed, the matted lock rests majestically on his mountain-like shoulders. The Chandrama, the crescent moon, the Tripun, the three marks of the Bhashma, and the beautiful beaded malas lovingly adorn his neck. This beautiful form of Bhagwan Shankar, glorified even by Gauri Mata, Lord Vishnu and the host of the Devatas, that beautiful form we take into our minds and hearts, and we mentally worship the feet of Bhagwan Shiva Shankar.
Jai Shiva Omkara, Hare Shiva Omkara.
Everyone follow.
Jai Shiva Omkara, follow Hare Shiva Omkara. Om Hare 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 Mahadev,
follow Hare 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 Mahadev.
Pray together.
Hare 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 Mahadev. Chaturanan Panchanan Raje,
bolo.
Ekanan Chaturanan Panchanan Raje, bolo. Hansasan Garurasan Vrishvahan Saje,
bolo.
Jai Shiva Omkara, Hare Shiva Omkara. Shiva Omkara, Hare Shiva Omkara, Om Hare 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 Mahadev,
Om Hare 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 Mahadev,
Om Hare 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 Mahadev,
Om Hare 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 Mahadev.
Close your eyes and sing the beautiful name of Bhagwan Shankar.
Bam Bhola Bhola Bhola, Bam Bhola Bhola Bhola, Bam Bhola Bhola Bhola, Bam Bhola Bhola Bhola, Bam 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 Bhola Bhola, Bam 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 Bhola Bhola,
Bam 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 Bhola.
Satyam Shivam Sundaram Ishwar Satya Hai, Satya Hi Shiva Hai, Shiva Hi Sundar Hai, Satyam Shivam Sundaram, Satyam Shivam
पति महादेव की जय, पवन सुख हनुमान की जय, राज रामचंद्र की जय। सभी श्रोतागण अपना आसन पर बैठिए, प्लीज बी सीटेड एवरीवन। जय सिया राम। I bow most reverently tonight to the feet of Pandit Kiran Maharaj Ji, the Guru of the Mandir, and of course, one of the grandsons in the family, my brother Pandit, Thank you so much for your invitation to share with your family and your Aji and your relatives and your Mandir and the community in this very joyful celebration. Shri Pandit Narad Maharaj Ji and all the Pandits who may have blessed this family and this home with their presence tonight. And to all my respected elders, I bow most reverently, for you are really the manifestation of the sages and saints tonight. You add to the antiquity, the divinity, to the assembly whenever we meet like this in these joyous and momentous occasions. Tonight I want to recognize the presence of the radio stations that are here, Sankhya TV, who are covering and recording. For those who are listening to us via the airways of the radio station, wherever you are, we share with you the divinity of the pujas that would have been conducted, the Vedi Puja, the most elevated and the highest form of worship, whereby the devotee is able to recognize with God as a manifestation of this entire cosmos. We say ground puja, but there is no terminology like ground puja. What we say and what we refer to that worship is the Vedi puja, or the actual recognition or the identification of the devotee with the superiority of God, who really is a manifestation of this vast cosmos. And so we invoke the presence of the deities in their various forms, in their various attributes. The icon of the Kalsa, the center of the Vedi, enabling us to really understand that here at the center of the Vedi, we have what is called the centripetal force, the pivot or the very foundation of our existence. Whenever in your puja, your Pandit will give to you the Kalsa for the sthapana or for the consecration of that Kalsa, in the mantras there within, we are reminded that without God as our foundation, without God as our pivot, we are nothing. We are empty and we are void of any kind of virtue in this world. And this is why the Kalsa is so important, that it is recognizing that really God is our foundation. What is a home without God? And what is a house without a foundation? Verily, the strength of your home is the foundation that you place there. And this is in the consecration of that Kalsa, we remind ourselves every opportunity we have to do puja that Prabhu, you are our strength, you are our happiness, you are our joy, you are our light, you are our inspiration, you are everything to us.
He Prabhu Anandadata Gyan humko dijiye, shikr sare dur guno ko, shikr sare dur guno ko dur humse kijiye. He Prabhu, I am nothing without you, for you are my happiness, my health, my wealth and my joy. Lijiye humko sharan mein, hum sadachari bane.
Oh, Prabhu, when the wages of the world would weigh heavy upon me, when my shoulder sinks beneath the ocean of despondence and despair, when the world becomes gloomy and my path is narrowed, Prabhu, you are the one. You are my only one. You are my chosen one.
Data ek Rama, Data ek Rama, Bhikari sari duniya, Ram ek devata, Ujjari sari duniya data ek Rama data ek Rama.
And in tonight's message, you will see these words reflective in the teachings of Bhagwan Shankar to his consort Parvati Devi. You know, many a times you hear some dulahins complain, my dulaha do have no time for me. You hear some dulahas complaining that my dulahin is so busy and she's always engaged in all kinds of things. But tonight, there's a beautiful conversation between Lord Shiva and Parvati that gives us and it encapsulates really the message of the three nights of the yajna. But the theme for tonight's message, God is that chosen one and should be your chosen one. And my friends, in tonight's message, Lord Shiva relates to Parvati on the significance of having that support, that backbone and that pivot, as I mentioned, on the significance of the Kalsa. Sitting down there, performing your puja allows you to establish a higher conscientious communication with a divine being. Performance of the puja and the rituals would be only one step in your advancement towards becoming more conscientious of who you really are. And who are you? Who am I? We are symbols of that divinity. It encapsulates, my friends, the message of tonight's katha as Bhagwan Shiv Shankar speaks so beautifully to Parvati Devi. And so we are so blessed that this mother who crossed 90 years had this innate desire, this latent desire that tonight manifests in bringing all her children and all her grandchildren and her great-grand and a community together and the country together by sharing the message to wherever you may be. There are some of you who might be driving to work. There are some of you who might be now going to work, for those of you who are working the night shift. Some of you might be in work and listening in your hammock, in your cars, wherever you may be. I want to let you know that we're in a beautiful village called Barrackpore, in a beautiful mandir that is so beautifully decorated and bedecked by these beautiful murtis, icons of divinity that fill you with so much of energy and strength. My entrance into the mandir today brought so much of good and positive vibrations, and immediately the presence of the murtis disciplined the mind and you forget everything else that is worldly and sometimes oppressive. And so it is in that backdrop and with that background that I bring to you tonight's beautiful message as Lord Bhagwan Shankar speaks to Parvati and by extension Valmiki ji and Tulsidas ji to all of us tonight in the beautiful pages of the Balkand of Ram Charit Manas. Please repeat after me, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Now Pandit Kiran, I'm absolutely sure that we don't have 20, nor 30, nor 100, nor 200. We have more than 300 people here. And I'm only hearing about four voices. So we're going to try that one more time again. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Siaram. Bolo Yadhyapati Ramachandra Ki. Now, sing two lines of this beautiful chant with me as we glorify the name of Shri Ramchandra Ji. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram. Bolo bhaiya.
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram.
Jai Jai Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram. Jai Jai
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita
Ramachandra. while you sing, I want you to do two things. I want you to think of what you are saying, and I want you to feel the love in your heart for God. Glorify the name of Jai Shri Ram, sing the name of Jai Shri Ram. So don't only sing with the lips. I want you to sing from the heart. So we're going to put a little more love and a little more devotion and sing to Shri Ram. Jai Raghupati Raghav Raja. Bolo.
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patit Pavan Sita Ram.
Sita Ram, Jai Sita Ram, Bhaj Pyare.
Chandra Bhagavan ki.
Devotees, close your eyes. Think of that beautiful form of Shri Ganesh Bhagavan.
Om Varnanam Artha Sanghanam Rasanam Chandra Samapi Mangalanam Chakartaro Bandevani Vinayaka.
Mr. Ganeshji, the embodiment of all auspiciousness, the son of Shivji and Gaura Parvati, whose blessings allows us to achieve the highest pinnacle of success, who wins for us all auspiciousness, who removes all our calamities and misfortunes. To the feet of Lord Ganesh we bow again and again.
Om Gananam Tva Ganapati Gum Havamahi Priyanam Tva Priyapati Gum Havamahi Nidhinam Tva Nidhipati Gum Havamahi Vyasomama. Om Namo Ganapataye Namo Pramatapataye Namo Namaste Lambodaraye Kadantaye Shivasutaye Gaurinandanaye Namo Namaha.
Pray. Bless your home, your family, your children.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namo Nama Sri Siddhi Vinayak Namo Nama Ashtavinayak Namo Nama Ganapati Bapa Moriya.
Pray to the Lord that wisdom may come to us, spiritual guidance may come, and that whatever we do, Shri Ganesh would bless us to be successful, to be progressive, to be productive.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namo Nama Sri Siddhi Vinayaka Namo Nama Ashtavinayaka Namo Nama विनायक नमो नमः गणपति बापा मोरिया ओम गम गणपतये नमो नमः श्री सिद्धि विनायक नमो नमः अष्ट विनायक नमो नमः गणपति बापा मोरिया
एवरीवन
ओम गम गणपतये नमो नमः श्री सिद्धि विनायक नमो नमः अष्ट विनायक नमो गणपति बापा मोरिया गणपति बापा मोरिया गणपति बापा मोरिया
श्री गणेश भगवान की सरस्वती महाभागे विद्ये कमल लोचनी विद्यारूप विशालाक्षी विद्यांदेही नमो नमः भवानी शंकरो वंदे श्रद्धा विश्वांसरूपिनो याभ्यां दिनान पश्यन्ति सिद्ध स्वांतस्तमीश्वरम् I bow to the feet of Sharada Devi Ma Saraswati. Bless us, O Mother, that whatever teachings would come from the holy Puranas, the Ramayana, the scriptures, the Vedas, that they may serve as instructions to us to live our lives and to discipline our minds and bodies to understanding that we are symbols of divinity and to bring positive progressive changes in our lives.
Bande Bodhamayam Nityam Gurum Shankar Rupinam Yamasrito Hi Vakro Api Chandra Sarvatra Vandhyate.
Salutations to the feet of Bhagwan Shivan Parvati.
Sitaram Gunagramam Punyaranyah Viharino Vande Vishuddha Vijnano Kavishwara Kapishwaro Udbhavastiti Samhar Karani Klishaharini सर्वे श्रेयस्करिं सीतं नतोहं रामवल्लभाम् यन्माया वृषवर्ती विश्वम् अखिलं ब्रह्मादि देवासुर यत्सदवाद मृषैव भाति सकलं राज्यो जता हि भ्रमं यत्पादवप्लवमेव हि भवाम् बोधे स्थितिर्शावतम् वंदेहमतम शेषकार परम रामाक्यम ईशम हरि रामाक्यम ईशम हरि नाना पुराण निगमगम सम्मतम यत रामायणे निगदितम क्वचिदन्यतो अपि स्वातः सुखाय तुलसी रघुनाथ गाता भाषा निबंधमति मांजुल मातनोति बोलो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम बोलो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम बोलो एवरीवन श्री राम जय जय
क्लोज योर आईज Picture that beautiful form of Bhagwan Shri Ram. Next to Shri Ram, there is Devi Sita. Next to the feet of Shri Ram, there is Pavan Putra Mahavir Swami. And of course, Jaya Lakshman. Put all your love and sing together. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Bolo Shri Ram,
Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Jehi Sumirat Siddhe Ho. सुमेरत सिद्धि होए गण नायक करिवर वधनम करो अनुग्रह सो बोधि राशि शुभ गुण सधन श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम बोलो
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
मोक होई वाचा
सुधया द्रव सकल कलिमल दहन
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram
Jai Jai Ram
Neela Saroju Hasha Neela Saroju
discussion that you could entertain, the most enlightening discussion that you can engage yourself in, the most glorious thing that you can listen to would be discussions that center around glorifying, understanding, appreciating, and more so living the Leela of Bhagwan. And this is why satsang is so very important. Devotees, our katha, as I mentioned to you, comes in a beautiful conversation between Lord Shiva and Parvati. Here it is, a mother and father. Bhagwan Shankar and Parvati epitomizes, they idolize. They are the icons of the ideal mother and father. And their discussion would allow them now to engage in constructive discussions of that Supreme Paramatma. And so, using that beautiful brush of poetic language, Tulsidasji Maharaj brings our mind very beautifully to this very dense forest region. And they are set in that depiction, beautiful trees laden and bending over with lush, ripe, beautiful fruits. The air is very crisp and fragrant. There are ponds of beautiful water rippling along the mountains, and they are chirping very merrily at the treetops, the various species of birds, the bees, the butterflies. And within this beautiful context, Lord Shiva engages Mother Parvati in a beautiful discussion we hear in this first chaupai of Ram's Katha. Bolo Siyavar Ramachandra ki!
Jai!
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai
spare time. What is spare time? You hear people talking about spare time all the time. When I had just gotten married, my dulahin, oh, we're on radio. I probably shouldn't say that because she might be listening. When I got married, I heard about something called quality time. Dulahin, for those of you who are married, dulaha, do you know what is quality time? Quality time is the time that every dulahin has to make for her dulaha. That is your dulaha's time for you, dulahin, to do anything that he would want you to do that he likes doing. And dulaha, quality time, is that time that you have to make and you must make for your dulahin to do anything that she likes to do. And that is very important. Because the day will come when if you are very fortunate and blessed to be like Mama, to be 90 and more, and if your consort is alive, you get back and you're thinking. When you reach that age, you know what you start thinking? You start thinking about the things that you would do. The simple little things that would have brought true happiness and true joy to you. Lord Shiva takes that quality time. He makes that quality time and he sits with Parvati. But to do what?
Sangha Sati Jaga Janani Bhava. Puje Rishi Akhileshwar Jani.
Lord Shiva, Bhagwan Shankar himself, he goes in search of August Muni, the sage who was born in the jar, and we'd hear about that and the dynamics of Hinduism and its applicability even to this age and even times that are yet to come. This sage that was born in a jar, Bhagwan Shankar went and sought him out and brought him, and in the presence of Bhavani Mata, Sati Devi, Bhagwan Shankar and his consort, they requested something that is very significant of August Muni. The words of Bhagwan Shankar, as it comes from the Kamban Ramayana, Bhagwan Shankar says to the Muni, August Muni, that, O sage, you have blessed us today. Bless us meaning who? Meaning Bhagwan Shankar and Devi Mata. That, O August Muni, today you have blessed us. That our desire, our innate desire, is to feel the fulfillment of life by listening to a very fulfilling, uplifting, sanctifying katha of the glories of Bhagwan Shri Ramchandraji. Devotees. So Lord Shiva is requesting of August Muni to relate to us a message that is an uplifting message, a message that is a sanctifying message. The word sanctifying means that which brings purity and that which removes impurity, that which brings sattvic energies and powerful vibrations. O great sage, bless us by relating to us Ram's Katha. These are the words of Bhagwan Shankar as he now engrosses himself and engages himself together with Devi Mata by listening to the katha of Prabhu Shri Ramchandraji. And so, devotees, in that beautiful context of Tulsidas Ji's message, Lord Shiva now sits with rapt attention, his eyes, as it were, piercing into the lips of August Muni, as it were to draw out from his lips the nectar of the glories of the teachings of Bhagwan Shri Ramchandra Ji.
Ramayan katha sab ko pyara, pyara.
There is nothing more sweet, more divine and more sanctifying and fulfilling than Shri Ram's message.
Ramayan katha sab ko pyara, pyara.
Sing together, bolo.
Ramayan katha humko pyara pyara. Ramayan katha sabko pyara. Ramayan katha sabko pyara.
Bolo Syavar Ramachandra ki. And so, my friends, from the lips of August Muni, he chants the beautiful glories of Sri Ram's message. We listen in the next chaupai.
Jai Ram Sri Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Now you sing with me, everyone.
Jai Ram Sri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai.
Now let's try another method. I want you to sing from your heart. So don't let it only come from the lips. Sing, think of the Lord and express your love mentally. Everyone together, follow.
Jai Ram Shri Ram.
Ram Katha, and Lord Bhagwan Shankar listened with utmost delight to every single word that was uttered. The great seer, my dear devotees, relating to the love that Sri Shankar Bhagwan and Devi Mata had, he related the glories of Sri Ramchandraji, and my dear friends, much to the joy, much to the happiness, and much to the delight of Lord Bhagwan Shankar. My dear friends, at the end of the narration of Ram's Katha, there was a joy that filled Bhagwan Shankar. There was a happiness that could have been visibly seen in the expressions that Bhagwan Shiva depicted there. And this confused Devi Mata, this confused Sati Devi somewhat, until she questioned him. She said, "My Lord, since the narration of Ram's Katha, you have been in an ecstasy that is truly perturbing me indeed. Prabhu, I have seen you in joy and in happiness and in divine ecstasy, but nothing to compare as what I'm seeing now. What is it that would have entrapped you this much?" And my friends, Bhagwan Shankar related to Parvati that, "O Parvati, it is the glories of the message of love that comes from the narration of the virtues of Bhagwan Sri Ramchandraji." And my friends, Lord Shiva beautifully related to Parvati that, "O Parvati, every single advent in the Leela of Sri Ramchandraji was meant to uplift, to educate, to edify, and to empower us. Here it is that it may cause some confusion in our minds that we are listening to Lord Bhagwan Shankar, who is referred to as Devadidev Param Purushottam Bhaktivatsal Kripanidhan. Whenever we worship Shankar Bhagwan, we refer to Lord Shiva as Kripa Nidhan, limitless ocean of mercy, Kripa Sindhu, Daya Sindhu, he who is all powerful, all merciful, incomparable in might and in majesty." That how could this Sri Shankar Bhagwan be so mystified and so taken up in ecstasy in the glories of Sri Ramchandraji? And a beautiful message, my friends, comes as Bhagwan Shiva is relating to Sati Devi that, "O Parvati, the Ram's Katha is not merely the narration of history, but it is a reality that confronts you and I in our daily life." And Bhagwan Shiva took the time to explain to Parvati the importance of listening to Katha.
And this is something that is very significant to you and I, because as Hindus, no matter how difficult times may be, how trying times may be, we have continued to adhere to the teachings of our Ramayana. Yes, we love to go to the Yajna. We admire the antiquity. We admire the beauty of the mandirs and the decoration. We see the depiction of so much of love in all the artistic talent, in the preparation of the food, in the skills of the preparation of the prasad, in the beautiful singing of the bhajans, even in our clothing and how we conduct ourselves. So there is so much to admire when we hear of Ramayana and the Yajna. But what is more significant, that Bhagwan Shankar makes a very important point to Parvati, that, O Parvati, this Ram's Katha is the Puran. Puran means that it cannot be traced back to a particular time. Some people say 500 BC, 500 years before Christ, or 2000 years before Christ. But Bhagwan Shankar is saying to Parvati that this Katha is Purana, meaning it is ancient, it cannot be traced in time. And devotees, what is even more interesting for you and I is that August Muni would have just related the whole of Ram's Katha. August Muni sat as the Vyas, and the Shrota, the one who was listening to the Katha, listening to the message, was Bhagwan Shankar and Devi Mata. But here it is, at that same time, as soon as the Katha was finished, Devi Mata would have been a little confused that what would be the reason why you are so ecstatic. And Bhagwan Shankar says that, O Parvati, there is nothing more fulfilling in life and more heart-filling and satisfying than to listen to Ram's Katha. At that very said time, my dear devotees, something was taking place. Something significant was taking place. In a different region, not too far from where Shankar Bhagwan and Devi Mata was, my dear devotees, Bhagwan Vishnu had taken avatar as Sri Ramchandraji in the same Treta Yuga. As the son of Raja Dashrath, as the son of Kaushalya Mata, because of the father's demise, and because of the development of Katha, because of situations, Sri Ram had to be separated from his family. Sita Devi accompanied him. Bhaya Lakshman accompanied him. And there in the forest, Ravan got the urge to take away the Vedvati Sita. And it was there and then, and in that situation, that Sri Shankar Bhagwan says to Parvati, that, O Devi Mata, I am desirous of going to gain the darshan of Sri Ramchandraji. Will you accompany me? Will you join me in this most divine leela? What would happen? Tulsidas Ji relates in the next chapai.
Ram, Jai 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 Ram, Jai
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram
Sneh si chamari chahi sangha Bhayau turat so kapata turanga Jai Ram
Shri Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram
रामचंद्र भगवान की जय। एही विधि भय सोच बस ईसा तेही समय जाई दस शीशा। माय डियर डेवोटीज, श्री भगवान शंकर वाइल लॉस्ट इन एक्सटेसी हैविंग बीन सो एनग्रॉस्ड in the message of Sri Ramchandraji, and that same time Ravan, the ten-headed Dashanand, Dashmukh Ravan, fell in captured by the physical beauty of the Vedvati Sita and took her away into Lanka. Sri Ramchandraji, enacting the role of an ordinary mortal, now is so entrenched in sorrow, in sadness, and depicting all the emotions that you and I would go through in life. He's looking at the stars in the night and he's crying for Sita. In the day, he's questioning the sun god Surya about the whereabouts of Sita. He's looking at the earth and asking, what would he have done? Is it not that sometimes we ask ourselves that question when we are faced with the many challenges that life would bring? What are some of the questions we ask? What did we do to deserve this? What karma have we done in our past lives? What is it that I have to be confronted with such difficulties and such problems and all the emotions that would challenge you and I in life, my dear devotees, is now being depicted in the role of Sri Ramchandraji. And this is exactly what Bhagwan Shankar brings to Parvati. The relativity of Ram's Katha. The relationship between the message of God and the situation that life presents itself to you and I. And this is the very significant part of the Katha. That here it is that Bhagwan Shiva and Sati Devi would have just listened to the entire content of Ram's Katha from sage Agastya Muni. But at the same time, at that same present time, Bhagwan Sri Ramchandraji is walking upon the face of the earth, crying and weeping and wailing and depicting the role of an ordinary mortal, a role that depicts a life that you and I are sometimes confronted by. And now, in the mind of Sati, she's a bit confused. Because how is it that August Muni would have related the whole Ramayana for us? We just heard the entire Ramayana, it's in its totality. But yet Sri Ram is now walking the Dandak forest and Ravan is yet to be defeated. Sati is confused. And devotees, Bhagwan Shankar said to Parvati, to Sati Radha, that this scripture is Purana. It is ancient and it cannot be tracked by time. Some people say the Ramayana came in the Treta Yuga, but here it is that we are in the Treta Yuga and Sri Shankar Bhagwan just heard the entire content of the Ramayana. So is it not that Sati could then predict what is going to happen with Sri Ramchandra ji and the demise of Ravan, and yet Ravan is yet still alive? He would have just taken away the Vedvati Sita. What does it mean to you and I? It means, my friends, that even though the Ramayana is Puranic, that it is ancient history, the Ramayana remains yet relevant. And this is why in Hinduism, we refer to the Dharma that we belong to as Sanatan. Sanatan means it is eternal. So in other words, you cannot say that Hinduism is a practice of those who would have lived many millions of years ago or thousands of years ago, or Hinduism is practiced now, then we do not know the direction it will take in the years that are yet to come. Sati, like you and I, she is confused. What is the relevance that we heard the entire katha, but yet still the katha is still going on? My friends, it is very simple. We are presently living the Ramayana. The Ramayana is a living entity. And this is why, my friends, the Ramayana is so glorified. You would have noticed, for those of you who would have been here earlier on, that when the scripture came, the devotees came with so much of love and all the joyful musical instruments. They lifted the Ramayana at the top of their head. And with that beautiful procession, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, they brought it into the mandir and they placed it onto the Singhasan. This Ram's Katha, my friends, is Puranic. It is ancient millions of years ago. But it continues to live every day, very applicable and very relevant to you and I. Sati is confused. We just heard the entire Ramayana in its totality. But yet, Ravan is not yet destroyed. My friends, the Katha, the messages contained in Ramayana would remain relevant even hundreds and thousands of years after now. It is a living entity. And this is why we glorify the Ramayana, my friends, as the living manifestation of God. Bhagwan himself came here to teach us, to uplift us, to educate us, and to show us a path of solving every single challenge or difficulty that the Katha brings. Bhagwan Shankar, in the Kamban Ramayana, related a beautiful katha to same Sati Devi. Once Valmiki ji, after completing the Ramayana, Ram Shri Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram, he's looking for Shri Hanuman ji, and from the distance he's hearing that sound, Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram. And Valmiki traces the sound, and when he comes there, under the beautiful shade of the fig tree, Shri Hanumanji sits. Shri Ram Tumhare Mandir Mein Main Deep Jalam Aaya Hoon. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram. And Valmiki says to Hanuman that, here, O Hanuman, I have completed the entire manuscript of Ram's Katha. And Valmiki was so joyful to show the completed Ram's Katha to Shri Hanumanji. Hanumanji took it and he pressed it to his bosom. He said, "Oh Valmiki ji, I want to show you something now." And Bhagwan Shankar is relating this to Sati. And Shri Hanumanji brought out a pile of banana leaves. If I say fig leaf, you'll know what I'm talking about, right? And you know those long fig leaves like this? And with the fingernails of Sri Hanumanji, he etched the entire advent of the Leela of Sri Ramchandraji. With his fingernails, he impressed the entire Ramayana on fig leaves and compiled this much on the glories of Sri Ram. And when he showed it to Valmiki, tears started flowing from the eyes of Valmiki. Valmiki became extremely sad indeed. And when Sri Hanumanji saw how sad and how depressed Valmiki looked, he asked, he said, "Oh great sage, why do you look sad?" He says, "Oh Hanumanji, I have put so much of love into compiling this Ram's Katha that I thought that it would have been a source of inspiration, not knowing that you have given so much of love and your inscription with your fingernails on those banana leaves, it was the manifestation of the purest love." You know what Sri Hanumanji did? He took all and he ripped it up into 1,000 pieces. He said, "Look Valmiki, if this is going to make you happy, we're going to use your Ramayana. I do not need that compilation on the fig leaves to remind me of Sri Ram. All I need, Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram. The name of Sri Ram is enough for me, O Valmiki." And he ripped all of the leaves into pieces. And he said, "O Valmiki, if I have Ram in my heart, then there is no need for that physical Ramayana. Oh Valmiki, my Ramayana is a selfish Ramayana." Listen to the words of Hanumanji. "My Ramayana is a selfish Ramayana because I wrote that only for myself. But I recognize that there is no need for it when Ram is inside of me. Oh Valmiki, your Ramayana was written to inspire the lives of millions of devotees. Go with my blessings today." Hanuman Baba bless Valmiki, that may those who would listen to your katha have a heart like mine to be filled with Rama Bhakti. Wherever your katha would be read, the villages, the surrounding areas would become symbols of virtues. Even the greatest of sinner who would listen to your katha, even if with love they will chant one line of your writings, O Valmiki ji, would bear the very said blessings that I would gain from chanting the entire Ramayana and singing the glories of Bhagwan Sri Ram." So says a beautiful bhajan that really encaptures the love that Pavan Putra ji has for Sri Ramchandra ji. Bala Pavan Sudha Hanuman ki.
Bajrang bari meri naav chali, karuna kar paar laga dena, karuna kar paar laga dena. Bajrang bari meri naav chali, karuna kar paar laga dena, karuna kar paar laga dena. He Mahavira, Parlokira, Satmarg Mohe dikha dena, Satmarg Mohe dikha dena. Vajrang bari meri naav chali, karuna kar paar laga dena. Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Thank you.
सियावर रामचंद्र की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय। ब्यूटिफुल वर्ड्स इन द राइटिंग्स ऑफ तुलसीदास जी इन दिस ब्यूटिफुल चौपाई।
हो जय राम श्री राम, जय राम श्री
everyone. Sati Devi had a question plaguing her mind, an inquisition that brought a little discomfort when she relayed her plight and when she relayed her doubt to Bhagawan Shankar. Sati Devi was uncomfortable and very perturbed. Lord Shiva read her so very well, you know, in a relationship. The more you grow, and every time in a relationship you celebrate an anniversary, and I always tell people this, do not celebrate your anniversary if when you celebrate your anniversary, you do not have two times as much love for your dulha and your dulahin as you had the year before. If your love begins to dwindle, then stop celebrating. An anniversary, a wedding anniversary becomes significant when as a husband you could say to your dulahin, babe, or however you, I don't know how you call your dulahin or your dulha, my love for you is two times as much as I had for you last year. Of course, if she's not accustomed to that, she might faint and fall down and so on. But Bhagwan Shankar, he was able to read Parvati. You know, quite a number of years ago, I did a puja for a couple. I think it's Cedras. Is either Cedras or Granville? A very old couple. And they were celebrating their 65th wedding anniversary. And you know what? I ask. Well, everybody call her Nani. I said, Nan, what is it, if someone would ask you, would be the reason for having to spend so many years married and together and living so well together? She said, Baba, you had to know to read your dulaha. She said, if my dulaha raise the eyebrow, so I know what I had to do. If he twitch, he knows, so I know what not to do. If the airs move a little bit, I know time to run. So she is saying, you know, after a while, you must be able to read each other without even speaking. And it happens the more you grow in love together. And so Bhagwan Shankar, he's seeing the uneasiness in Sati. And he goes to, he said, Devi, something is bothering you. So in one end, Sati was able to see the ecstasy of Bhagwan Shiva having now listened to Ram's Katha. Is it not yes or no? That when the Baba leaves your home and puja finished and everybody gone, the happiest you ever feel is when you puja finish. Yes or no? Yes. There's a feeling of joy. The place feels different altogether. I did a puja for a family yesterday or day before. And just as I was leaving and sitting in the car, the dulaha said to me, said, Baba, you know the happiest I just ever feel. And it's not the first time, you hear it all the time. When my puja finished, there's a different feeling of joy and there is a feeling of fulfillment that nothing else brings. And it was that feeling that Sati was able to see in Shankar Bhagwan. And when she asked him, he says, this is Ram Prem. It is the love for Sri Ram. Just as Hanumanji said to Valmiki, Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Chandra Bhagavan ki. And so now Bhagavan Shankar is seeing in Parvati. And he's asking her, how could you be as a husband? How could you be happy and life as usual? And your dulahin is unhappy, uneasy and restless. If you don't care, if this is the situation with your dulahin, then something is wrong with you. Bhagwan Shankar go, tell me what is it? And then she says to him, she says, Prabhu, what is it about this Ram that you're so mystified over? That you left and you went and you're asking me to accompany you to go on to gain the darshan of Ram. Bhagwan Shankar says, Devi, this is God himself that came on the earth. This is Bhagwan Vishnu himself, and the Lord came to set standards and to put a meter for which we could measure ourselves by and to lift up ourselves to meet that level of perfection. In other words, my friends, in life, we can't just live. I love to use this word. You would have heard me using it before. Idhar udhar. You know what is idhar udhar? Anyhow, he swing, lay hang. Or anyhow, he hang, lay swing. Inverted commas. You can't be living anyhow, you take it, dice how it go. Where Monday meet you, your head fall. Where Friday meet you, dice where you are. No, bhaiya. You must have some kind of vision, something, some bigger picture that you want to achieve in life. God sets that standard for you and I. And the standards that God is setting is highlighted in the scriptures. And this is why again I tell you that in as much as we worship the scriptures, we cannot only worship the scripture and put a flower by the Ramayana and do aarti. The scripture has to become a part of our lives. We have to make our lives the scripture. You are the Ramayana, you are the Hanuman, you are the Sita, and we sometimes enact the role of the Ravan. So Bhagwan Shankar makes a beautiful point to Sati when he says to her, O Sati, we are the scriptures. We are the Ram. We are the Sita. If it is that there is a question in your mind, there is a doubt in your heart, then go. What he says to her? Chale Sita Shiva Aya Supai Karahi Vicharu Karo Kabhai. Go and use Vivek. Use your critical judgment. And devise some means by which you could rest your mind at ease. That ordinary mortal that you are seeing is none other than the Lord himself. And so friends, in the final chaupai, what does Sati Devi do? She goes now in search of Sri Ram, going now to test the might of Sri Ram. How powerful is our scripture? How virtuous would be the messages of our scripture? Could our God, the Lord that we worship and in whose grace we live, could that very said Lord impact my life in any way at all? What is the value of all of the Ramayana and the teachings of our forefathers? What significance does it have to you and I? In that great doubt, Sati ponders and she goes now to test the faith of Sri Ramchandra ji.
Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai.
walking the forest, looking and searching for the Vedvati Sita. Sati Devi, the consort of Bhagwan Shankar, the wife of Lord Shiva, she goes and she sees the state of the mind of Sri Ram. Sati, the wife of Lord Shiva, takes the form of Sita Devi, and in the Sita form, she goes before Bhagwan Sri Ramchandra Ji. What will happen, friends? Tulsidas Ji writes, takes the form of Sita, and she goes where Sri Ram is searching for Sita Devi. And the minute Sri Ram sees Sati Devi in the form of Sita, he bows his head right down. Ma, why are you wandering in the forest like this? Where is my Lord Shiva? Devotees, she fell unconscious immediately on the ground. She could not believe that there and then was the manifestation of the Lord God Absolute, who came on the earth with a purpose, to fulfill a purpose, to set a standard, to recognize. God recognizes with every single pain and problem and difficulty and sorrow. Many of us, my friends, the first thing we say, God doesn't know what I'm going through, nah? Nobody knows what I'm going through. But my dear devotees, Sati Devi experiences in her own humble way the might and the greatness of Sri Ramchandra Ji. Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai
Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
State of unconsciousness, she regained herself. She made mental prostrations to the feet of Bhagwan Sri Ram, and immediately, very quietly, she went back to where Bhagwan Shankar was. Lord Shiva saw her. Sati, how did you fare? What took place? You know what she said to Bhagwan Shiva? She says, Prabhu, I saw the Lord Sri Ramchandra Ji. I saw the love and the divinity within his divine form, and I simply bowed my head. I bowed my head and I took his blessings and I came back. I returned to you. Devotees, did she speak the truth? Did she utter the truth? No. What she said was in fact the untruth. And Bhagwan Shankar, being the Lord of the universe, he saw through this, and a mental oath he took that, O Sati, while you are yet in this form, I will physically separate myself from you. You have taken the form of the mother of the universe and gone, as it were, to trick the Lord. Today, I take this sankalp that in this form, I will honor you only as I give honor to the Devi Sita, and no other physical contact will come. So saying, my dear friends, Bhagwan Shankar became physically separated from his consort Sati Devi. And of course, as the Devi Bhagavat will tell us, many years would have passed and Sati Devi would have consumed herself in the fire of the Yajna of Raja Daksha. Next time, when we have Devi Bhagavat, we would listen to that katha and how that said Sati Devi was incarnated in the form of Parvati and was once again wedded to Bhagwan Shankar as Shiva and Parvati Devi. Bolo Sri Umapati Mahadeva ki, Siyavar Ramachandra ki. And so, my friends, Thursdays are days we dedicate our devotion to that beautiful form of Mahadev, Bhagwan Shiva Shankar. There is a beautiful bhajan that I want to conclude, just two lines of that bhajan with you, that glorifies Shivji. And the bhajan says, O Lord Shiva, you are the source of all happiness, the fountain of unending joy, the abode of all goodness and virtue. We glorify thee again and again. Bhole Nath se nirala, Gauri Nath se nirala, koi aur nahi. Nowhere again, O Shivji, could I find a love that is greater than the love that I have for you. Again and again, Prabhu, may you bless me and fill my life with happiness and joy. May all the emptiness of my life be filled with your blessings. O Shivji, again and again, your blessings I see. Bhole Nath se nirala, Gauri Nath se nirala, koi aur nahi. Bhole Nath se nirala, Gauri Nath se nirala, koi aur nahi. Aisa bigri banane wala, aisa bigri banane wala, koi aur nahi. Bhole Nath se nirala, Gauri Nath se nirala, koi aur nahi.
Bhole Nath se nirala. namah shivaya bolo om namah shivaya om 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 namah shivaya bolo
Satyam Shivam Sundaramo Satyam Shivam Sundaram Ishwar Satya Hai Satya Hi Shiva Hai Shiva Hi Sundar Hai Satyam Shivam Satyam Shivam Sundaram
Bolo Sri Mahapati Mahadev Ki Jai. And so devotees, as Shri Hanumanji said to Valmiki, that O Valmiki, my Ramayana is for my own self-gratification. I will destroy it and let your Valmiki, let your Ramayana live, so that it will inspire, it will touch, it will motivate, it will mold and uplift the lives of every single being who would live its eternal teachings. And so devotees, Bhagwan Shiva relating to Parvati, that O Parvati, this Ramayana Katha that we listened from the lips of Agast Muni is a living power that continues to motivate us, to uplift us, to edify us, to sanctify us, and to pull us to the pinnacle of perfection in all of life's aspirations. He says to Parvati, and in the words of Bhagwan Shankar, in the writings of Valmiki, that there is nothing to fulfill you more in life than to listen to the beautiful teachings and to live the teachings of our scriptures, that which is Puranic, ancient history, yet Sanatan, ever, eternally uplifting. This is my message to you, my dear devotees. Until again tomorrow night, through the instrumentality of the mother of this home, such a powerful icon herself of love and compassion, that she gives us all the opportunity to come together in prayer and in worship, and to share wherever our devotees may be listening the beautiful messages of the devatas and of all our lovely scriptures. Once again, my bhaiya Ramesh and his wonderful Dulahin from Sankhya TV, it is so nice to see all of you, and to all our listeners wherever you are, we share with you the love of this wonderful mother as she celebrates her 90 years and more, and the blessings of all her children. In fact, I think her eldest son celebrates his birthday today, and we want to wish him many, many more years of happiness, and her two other sons also, sometime during the course of this week. So it's a wonderful time of prayer and thanksgiving. Always remember, whenever you do prayer, you are given the opportunity to say, thank you, God, for all your blessings. May you continue to shower mercifully your grace and your blessings upon us now and forevermore. Bolo Siyavara Ramachandra Ki! And so, my friends, I invite you now to stand as we will join in the final arti. Om Sajam Savrate Samyuktam Vahena Yojitam Maya Deepam Grihana Devasya Trilukmirapam Yani kani sapapani janantra katani vinashanti pradakshinanam pade pade. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Pray together.
Har 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 Mahadev. Om Har Har Har
भोला भोला
शिव भोला भोला भोला
close your eyes. We pay salutations to the Universal Mother as we glorify her.
Ma, teri mamta kitni pyari, kitna pyar jagati hai. Ma, kitna pyar jagati hai.
Ma, we celebrate the blessings of Mother Durga, Mother Lakshmi and Mother Saraswati, that you have blessed us, being present with us for so many years, Ma. May you continue to live long to bless us, your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. May your presence with us continue to inspire us to reach the pinnacle of success in all that we do, Ma. May your blessings allow us to live long, to enjoy health, to enjoy prosperity. Ma, as we celebrate your birthday, we pray only that you would continue to be strong and healthy, if just to lift your hands to bless us, your children. May your presence continue to affirm us all that strong foundation. May we continue the legacy that you have taught us, and that you will continue to teach us, that we may be symbols of your love and your teachings. Ma, as we celebrate your birthday, we, your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren and all your loved ones, we glorify you. You are our Durga, our Lakshmi, our Saraswati.
Raksha karti swas swas ki, raksha karti pag pag pran bachati hai, kitna pyar jagati.
Prakriti Swabhava Karomi Yajyat Sakalam Parasme Narayana Iti Samarpayami Achyutam Keshavam Ramana Rayanam Krishna Damodhavam Vasudevam Hari Shridharam Madhavam Gopika Vallavam Janaki Nayakam Ramacham
Bolo!
Hare Rama Hare Rama Ram Ram Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Ram Ram Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Ram Ram Hare Hare Krishna Krishna Hare Hare Ram Ram Hare Hare Krishna Krishna
Mangalam Bhagavan Vishnur Mangalam Garudar Bhajam Mangalam Pundarikaksham Mangalayatano Hari Om Shanti, 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 Jyoti Bindu,
Paramatma Se.
की जय जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय उमापति महा
जगन्नाथ की जय। बोलो भाई सब संतन की,
सत्य सनातन धर्म की
जय। नाउ द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट टीचिंग ऑफ रामायण,
श्री राम में
सब जग जानी। See God in everything and everyone. I want you, do not stand up where you are. I want you move from where you were standing or sitting. And I want you to greet everyone.
Sita Ram, Sita Ram.
Bhaiya. Bolo.
Sita Ram, Sita Ram. Sita Ram kahiye. Jahi vidhi rakhe Ram. Jahi vidhi rakhe Ram. Tahi vidhi rahiye. सीताराम 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 कहिए,
जाहि विधि रखे राम ताहि विधि रहिए।
सीताराम 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 सीताराम
सीताराम चंद्र की जय।
बैठिए, प्लीज बी सीटेड वेरी कंफर्टेबली। भगवान्स ब्लेसिंग्स to all of you.
Right. A very special thank you to Bhaiya KC for doing the honors for us with the tabla, wonderful musically accompanied by my brother Bhaiya Kelvin ji also, and of course to all of you for making this evening very, very special.